Hello, this is Dr. Lori Langdon with our next installment, and today's topic is crazy things that newborns can do even when they're normal. I think one of the most terrifying things in the world is bringing home a newborn from the hospital and you feel like you have no instructions. So today's video hopefully will help you feel better equipped to take care of your normal newborn. One of the things babies can do that scares a lot of parents is called periodic breathing, and this means that they will sometimes rapidly pant and then pause. And both things are scary, that they're breathing so fast and then that they pause and you don't know what's wrong. But actually this is okay and it's normal. Newborns have a very immature control center. Their respiratory control center is in their central nervous system is just immature and not very well able to regulate their respiratory rate. So you'll see really fast rates and then slow rates, and that's okay. As long as they're not showing sustained increased respiratory rate or any other signs of difficulty breathing, then you're actually just fine. And thank goodness they'll outgrow that, because it is scary looking to watch. Another thing that can happen is while the baby is in utero, the baby is exposed to high levels of maternal hormones. These maternal hormones are telling the mom's body to create more breast tissue so that it'll be able to produce milk. Well, it turns out both baby girls and baby boys also have breast tissue, and their tissue also responds to those exact same hormones. So your baby may have a very firm area beneath the nipple on either one or both sides, and that's okay. Don't squeeze it or push it or mash it or anything like that. It's normal and it'll go away on its own and shouldn't cause you any concern or alarm. Another thing babies do all the time, it's, I think, hilarious, but they just sneeze, even if they don't have a cold, even if they're not sick and there's no fever. It's just the only way they have to clear their upper airway, so they'll sneeze a lot, and that's okay. Don't be alarmed by that. Similarly, they will get the hiccups multiple times every single day. In fact, a lot of babies had hiccups even when they were in utero, so you may remember before you delivered feeling a little recurring jiggle in there, and that was probably hiccups also. Some babies will hiccup more just after they've either spit up or at least refluxed a little bit up into their esophagus, and that'll trigger some hiccups too. It is harmless. It doesn't cause any pain or distress to the baby, so you don't really have to do anything for the sneezing or for the hiccups. The other thing that happens a lot is nasal congestion. Normal newborns, without a cold, without a fever, without trouble breathing or anything, can still have some nasal congestion. Part of that is they just have a lot of blood supply to the blood vessels in the nose, so they'll create mucus because the cells, the goblet cells, the mucus-producing cells are in the nose. They're getting all that blood supply. Then the other problem is they have really skinny little nasal passages, so that mucus will accumulate. You can do several things for this. It is safe to use nasal saline, which is just salt water, one or two drops in each nostril, followed by the bulb syringe. You guys should have been given a bulb syringe from the newborn nursery at the hospital to take home with you. And you just push it, insert, and pull back, and you can try to get any of that mucus out of their nose to help them breathe easier. Sometimes they can feed better if you'll do that suctioning before you attempt the feeding, so they can breathe better while they're trying to nurse. Also, for severe cases of nasal congestion, we'll recommend using a cool mist humidifier near the baby's bassinet or crib. Another common problem we see in every single baby is dry skin. So here's the reason for that. Think about it. This baby's been in utero, in fluid, in the amniotic fluid for these 9 months, right? And so after they're delivered, the surface, it's almost as if all of their skin is eventually gonna just slough off, and it looks very, very dry, and this is normal. Now, the baby doesn't need an actual baby bathtub bath where it gets wet, especially gets its belly wet, until after the umbilical cord has fallen off. And once that's happened, then it is okay for the baby to get a bath, but the bath's only gonna dry them out even more. So until the cord's off, just continue to sponge bathe as needed, which isn't very often because they're not really very dirty. And for the dry skin itself, nothing's actually required. If you want to put a fragrance-free moisturizing cream on them, you can, but it's not necessary. Here's the most distressing thing that newborns can do, so just prepare yourself. Babies get their days and nights confused, and this is normal. So think about when you were still pregnant, and during the daytime you were walking and gently rocking that baby to sleep, right? And it seemed pretty calm. You'd feel motion, certainly, but not all the time. And then as soon as you went to lie down and sleep at night, the baby's having a party and coming to life in there and going crazy. Well, that very same pattern continues after the baby's born. It's gonna be more groggy during the day, take longer naps, and then wanna party all night. Now, we don't want that to continue, obviously, but I just don't want you to be afraid that there's something wrong with your baby because it's doing that. They all do that. All you can really do is encourage more frequent feeds during the day, try to let the baby stretch out feeds a little bit overnight. Never let a newborn baby go more than 3 to 4 hours without feeding, even overnight. But if you could get it to eat more frequently during the day and stretch out overnight, you'd get a little bit more sleep, which is helpful. And this is when you want to use all your backup support. If someone can come over and hold the baby, let you take a quick nap during the day, that would be fantastic, because you've got to keep up your energy to take care of the baby. Think of this as a marathon, not a sprint. You've got to pace yourself, take naps, use your help as you can to survive these sleepless nights that can last for a while. Another thing that can happen is, let's talk about the diaper area. For little baby girls, which are harder to wipe because there's so many nooks and crannies, they can have a normal mucousy vaginal discharge. In fact, in the first few days of life, it can be blood tinged. What's happening is, we were talking about exposure to maternal hormones when they were in utero. Same for down there. They got exposed to mom's high level of hormones, so they're creating a lot of vaginal mucousy discharge. But then also, when that level of hormones crashes, they can have a little mini or withdrawal period. So if you see some blood mixed in, that's actually okay. And remember, as you're wiping, if it's just clear or a whitish mucousy discharge, you do not have to scrub that. You're only going for stuff that's got color, meaning it's poop. If it's come up into the front, you want to wipe that out gently so that she won't get a urinary tract infection. The other thing I have parents ask me about all the time, they're afraid that their baby's already spoiled because every time you lay that baby down, it starts to cry. But when you hold it and snuggle it and rock it and provide some motion, it quits crying. So they think, oh my goodness, my baby's already spoiled. A newborn baby is not spoiled. It was just used to being inside where it was warm and snuggled and swaddled and could hear your heart beating and feel your body temperature. And it just prefers that because that's what it's used to. So you're not going to spoil your baby by holding it all the time. Now, also, it's fine if you need to put your baby down for a minute to go use the bathroom or to take a shower or something like that. Absolutely fine. But I don't want you to feel bad if you have a volunteer grandmother who's willing to hold the baby while you take a shower. That's perfectly acceptable. You're not going to spoil it yet. It's just a newborn. It's actually wonderful if you have enough spare people to help out with that. The other thing early on that a lot of parents become concerned about is spitting up. And we're going to do a whole video on gastroesophageal reflux. Because it's so important and so common and such a frequent problem we discuss. But I just want you to know, for normal newborns, especially as they begin to take in more and more volume with each feeding, of course some of it may come back up because they have a very floppy lower esophageal sphincter, LES, and its tone comes and goes. And so when it's very relaxed, whatever the contents of their stomach are going to come right back up, and that's very common as well. So some spitting up in the newborn period is not scary for us as long as the baby still has good weight gain. Now the exception for that is if you're suddenly seeing fewer urine diapers, fewer stool diapers, and the spit up itself isn't just spit up, it's extremely forceful. I mean, literally can shoot across the room. We call it projectile vomiting. That's a different thing and could be more serious, and you need to let us know about that. And as always, remember, all of this is general medical advice and does not apply to your specific baby. You should always get routine well child care as recommended by your own child's pediatrician and seek sick or urgent care as necessary. Thank you so much.